在我们还没开始我们的会前时钟，请大家一起跪下来做个祷告。Before we begin our hymnal session, let us kneel down and pray. Sebelum kita mulakan sesi kidung, mari kita sama-sama sujud dan berdoa.
La 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 Thank you. 奉主耶稣圣名领诗，请大家唱诗第91首 In the name of Lord Jesus I lead him, sing him 91. Dalam nama Tuhan Yesus saya memimpin kidung, nyanyi kidung nombor 91. Sing him hymn 87, nyanyi kidung 87. Thank you. Index Hymn 101, 唱下一首诗第101首 Nyanyi Kidung 1001. 101. 112首 Sing the next same 112 Nyanyi Kidung 112. Thank you. 第287首，新诗 next hymn 239首。Nyanyi Kidung 239. Tuhan, sesi kidung sampai di sini. 感谢主，我们颂诗到此。Thank God, our hymn session end here. Amen.
Hallelujah, 各位长子兄弟姐妹，大家晚上平安。
Hallelujah, ministers, brothers and sisters, very good evening to all of you.
我们同心默祷预备新聚会。
Let us say a silent prayer to prepare our hearts for the service.
阿门。
阿门。
奉主耶稣圣名开始晚上的聚会。
In the name of Jesus, we commence our evening service.
大家起立唱赞美诗429首。
Let us all arise to sing hymn 429.
Thank you.
好，我们同心祷告，求主祝福带领晚上的聚会。
We shall now pray. We beseech the Lord's guidance and blessing in our service this evening.
使我们所讲的合乎神的旨意。
That everything we share this evening will be in accordance to God's will.
使所听的都能够听明白神的旨意。
That we will be able to understand God's will.
来同祷告。
In Jesus' name, let's all kneel down to pray.
奉主耶稣圣名祷告。哈利路亚，感谢赞美主耶稣，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚。感谢主耶稣，阿们。奉主耶稣圣名正道。
In the name of Jesus, I speak.
靠着圣灵的帮助。
Relying on the help of the Holy Spirit.
我们继续来分享讲解但以理书的信息。
We continue with the message of Daniel.
在第九章，我们分享了七个七的这个异象，这个异言。
In Daniel chapter 9, we shared the vision of the 77th.
那么在九章的二十六节当中，有预言，天使预言，真神的教会，神的国里面会发生五件大事。
In Daniel chapter 9, verse 26, the Holy Spirit prophesied that there will be five matters that will happen in the last days.
还记得那五件大事吗？
Do you still remember the five major things that will happen?
这五件大事都针对真教会神的国来发生的。
And these are what will happen in the church of God in the last days.
第一就是真教神的教会当中一定会有六十九个器里面要发生的事情。
In the church of God, there will be something that will happen in the 69 sevens.
但是你还记得六十九个器这段时间？神的国会发生什么？还记得吗
？But do you still remember what will happen during this period of the 69 sevens?
所以传道不重复了
So I shall not repeat.
好，那第二件事。
Second matter.
第二件事呢？过了六十九个期的时候，过了嘛哈？那受膏者必被剪除，就是弥赛亚主耶稣会被钉死。
After the period of 69 sevens, the anointed one will be cut off.
好，那第三件事，这个也是已经发生了。
This has also happened.
那第三件 第三件事
，the third matter，
必有一王的名来毁灭这城和圣所。
There is this prince who will come to destroy the city and the sanctuary.
这个是重复性的预言，多次性的发生。
This will be repeated many times.
那么在主后，主耶稣升天后七十年，真的发生了。
True enough, after the Lord Jesus ascended to heaven in the year AD 70, it happened.
有一王带着他的名来，他的兵啊，他的军兵，他的名来哈，毁灭耶路撒冷，也毁灭圣殿，一块石头也不留在上面。
There is this general who came to destroy the city of Jerusalem and the temple. Not one stone was left upon another.
但是这个预言呢，还有在将来耶稣再来之前的也还会再次发生的。
But this prophecy will also happen again, in the future.
那第四件事是什么呢
？What is the fourth matter？
第四件这里说，至终到最后呢，神的城和圣所必如洪水被冲没了。
The fourth matter is in the end of it, the city and the sanctuary shall be swept away with the flood.
至终被冲没，就是说他们挣扎了一段时间。教会哈、挣扎、抵挡、抵抗，这个恶势力这种洪水的冲击，抵抗了一段时间，到最后失败了，整个圣所、圣殿被冲走。
There will be a period of resistance where the church will try to resist against the flood, but in the end, it was still swept away.
以前我们看这段圣经哦，谈使徒教会都没有想到这一点。
When we were sharing on the Acts of the Apostles, we have not thought of this.
直到不上个星期，传道再次的在思想这段诗的时候，神的圣所被洪水冲去。我在想，神的圣所什么时候被洪水冲去？
Right,
一直在想的时候，突然间这个意念就跑出来，
right,
这个想法就跑出来。
Right until our last session, when we were discussing on the book of Daniel, and this topic came up, where the city and the sanctuary was swept away by the flood, and suddenly I had this insight.
使徒时代的教会就是被洪水冲去的呀。
The church during the apostolic period was swept away by the flood.
我在想这件事情的时候，突然间就是有这个意念，突然间很清楚的出现，使徒时代的教会就是被洪水冲走的呀，冲没的呀，冲没就是整个灭没，整个没有。
As I was thinking of this, it suddenly dawned on me that the apostolic church was actually swept by the flood and everything just diminished.
在但以理书哈，就早都预言了。
But it was already prophesied during the time of Daniel.
圣所就是指的是敬拜神的圣殿来的嘛，圣所是最最圣洁荣耀的地方嘛，圣所嘛，被洪水冲没，不是冲掉一点哦，冲没整个没有。所以使徒时代的教会全部倒啊，不是倒一两间，知道吗？全部倒啊，全部没有掉。
This sanctuary refers to the temple, and during the time of the apostolic period, all the churches were swept away.
这第四件事情也是已经发生了，就是在使徒时代教。
This fourth matter has already happened during the apostolic churches.
那么在将来耶稣再临的时候，还有没有这种洪水的冲没教会呢？
But in the future, before Jesus comes again, do you think the flood will again sweep the church?
主耶稣说还会有。
Jesus said yes.
所以主耶稣在启示录那边，你跟我们讲到那个龙在吐口水嘛，是吧
？That is why Jesus in Revelation it tells us about the dragon who spilled out water from his mouth.
吐啊，突然间他这个口水变成河啊，变成河水。
As the serpent was spilling out water from its mouth, suddenly it became a flood.
那主耶稣说，那将来我们的真教会就是末世真教会，一样要面对龙的洪水的冲击。龙的洪水的冲击还是一样会被洪水冲击。
Our Lord Jesus tells us that in the end times we will also experience this kind of flood sweeping us away.
但感谢神我们不会再像使徒时代的教会，所有真教会、真耶稣教会被洪水冲没，不，绝对不会发生，不再会发生这样的事，绝对不会。
But then we will no longer be likened unto the apostolic period where all the churches were swept away.
我们怎么这么肯定呢？
How can we be so sure?
那主耶稣接下去说，十二章启示录十二章的十六节说，神开了地的口，将那个龙吐出来的水把它吞了。神行了神迹能力来阻挡了龙的洪水。
Jesus said in Revelation chapter 12 verse 16, that when the flood came, then the earth the earth opened up its mouth and swallowed up the flood.
这是第一个相信的原因。
This is the first reason why we believe.
将来的真教会，现在的真教会绝对不会再被龙的洪水哦冲没，绝对不会，因为神在帮助，神行出能力来坚固。
That the church in the last days will no longer be swept away by the flood because God is helping and strengthening us.
第二件坚信的事情。
What is the second thing?
因为将来的真耶稣教会是被主耶稣借到天上去了。整个教会圣城被借到天上去了
because the true
不在地上了不被这被洪水这样冲击了不在了
The true church of the last days will be completely lifted up by the Lord to heaven. It will no longer be swept away by the flood.
如果真教会将来像使徒教会全部被冲没被 毁灭掉那么真教会怎么样被提上天呢、啊、真教会都没有办法被提上天啊知道吗
If the churchIs likened unto the apostolic churches where they are being swept away by the flood. Then how can the church be lifted up into heaven?
真教会到最后的时候要被提到天上去，这个是神的最大的能力、最大的荣耀，也是最精彩的部分，也是最荣耀、最精彩、最成功的部分。
The fact that our church will be lifted up into the heavens is the most glorious part of the second coming of Jesus.
所以传道很坚信的，非常相信的。末世的真耶稣教会绝对不会再被龙的洪水冲没了。那个但以理讲的预言，感谢主是停在使徒时代的教会，只应验在使徒时代的教会。
Therefore, I am deeply convinced that our true Jesus Church of the last days will no longer be swept by the flood. It is only the churches during the apostolic period.
但是你不要放心哦，那传道说啊，那圣经说我们不会被洪水冲走，你不要太放心哦。
But then let's not be too at ease.
你不谨慎，你的真理根没有扎稳，你一样会被龙的洪水、口水被冲走的呀。
If you are not watchful, then you will also be likened unto the churches that fell, and you will also be swept away.
末世的时候，个人的信仰被洪水冲走是有的，肯定是有的，而且现在就看得到的。
In the last days, our individual faith may be swept away by the flood, and it can already be seen today.
然后呢，一些教会单独的教会。好像我们的基隆坡教会，好像某某的怡保教会，好像某某煤炭山教会，单独的真耶稣教会，个别的他们不顺服的，有自己思考、自己路走的那些教会，全部都被冲走，都被冲走，不是没有哦。
There are also
还是会有被冲走的哦。
There are also individual churches which do not accept or do not completely submit to God's will, they will also be swept away.
我说不会被冲走，不是不像使徒时代的教会，全部所有的真教会被冲走，不会再这样。但是个别的教会还是会有，
When I say,
还是会被冲走。
When I say the churches in the true church in the last days will not be swept away by the flood, I mean it will not be completely swept away, just like during the apostolic period.
所以大家听清楚了啊。
So we must be very clear in this.
有人说哦，不会的，传道说不会的，根据圣经，谁跟你讲呀？
Do not think that because the preacher said no, it will not happen.
个别的、个人的还是会的。
The entire church will not be swept away, but the individual churches or the individual will.
末世真教会都是对主耶稣忠心，对真理忠心，坚持到底的，全部得救，全部被提上天上去。
But then, since most of the churches will still be loyal and faithful to our Lord Jesus Christ, they will all be lifted up to heaven.
就是第四件洪水要冲倒教会的这个预言当中，传道必须要讲清楚的。
This is what I should be very clear with you regarding this prophecy.
那第五件事是什么呢
？What is the fifth matter?
第五件事在真教会。在神国会发生的第五件事就是必有征战，看到吗
？The fifth matter that will happen in the kingdom of God is that this war.
二十六节的最后一段那边呢
？Verse 26, the last part, there will be war.
所以你以为你不用上战场啊，你就不会死啊
？Don't think that just because you
你不用上战场就不用打仗啊，你以为？
Don't think that just because you do not go to the battlefield, you do not have to fight the battle.
在真教会末世真教会里面，你要得救，你要生存，你唯一的办法，你就是要上战场，要抵挡到底，唯一的，一定要上战场。
For you to survive, in the last days in the church of God, you have to fight this battle.
因为必有战争啊。
Because there will be battles.
不会说没有战争的呀。
It is not possible that we will not.
原来我们的信仰哦，你进入真耶稣教会，你想要进入真教会，你来慕道的时候就开始战争了。 你在你的心里面就开始战争。
In actual fact, the minute you come to the True Jesus Church to seek the truth, you are already fighting a battle.
你想要洗礼的时候，你想要决定洗礼归入主的时候呢，就已经开始战争了，就有阻挡了，就有很多讥笑了，就有很多挣扎了，对吗？
When you are making the choice, the decision to get baptized, you are already facing this challenge, the battle.
其实我们真教会的信仰，真教会的信仰，主耶稣的信仰就是征战的信仰。
Actually, our faith in our Lord Jesus Christ is a faith of a battle.
那么战场在哪里呢？
Where is the battlefield?
我们常说战场在这个世界上，不是。
We always
那个也是其中一个而已。
We always say that the battleground is in the world, but it is only one of them.
真教会的战场就在真教会里面，在主耶稣的教会里面，在神的国度里面，神的国度里面，神的教会里面就是一场战场，战场就在教会里面。
The battleground is actually in the church, in God's temple.
你不信吗？
Do you not believe?
有鼻子，有拜子，有山羊，有绵羊，都在这里。有恶人，有善良的人，有恶仆，有忠心的仆人，有各种的这种善恶的，都在教会里。
So all,
这个不是一个，这里不是个战场吗？
All the testimonies about the good and the evil appearing in church. Don't you think this is a battleground?
然后自己要不要顺服神？自己还是要反抗真理？不顺服真理，这个也是场战场啊，也是一种挣扎呀。你选择要不要顺服呀？也是个战场呀。
Whether you want to accept the truth and submit to the truth, or you want to reject, and this is your own decision.
我一直以为战场在这个世界上。
We always think that the battle is in the world.
战场就在真教会里面，真教会里就是一场战场。
Our battleground.
战场的地方，战争的地方来的呀。
The church is our battleground.
原来信仰就是一场征战来的呀。
So our faith.It's also a life of faith.
一直到主耶稣来了，一直到我们自己主耶稣带我们走。
We fight this faith, we fight this battle right until Jesus comes again to take us to heaven.
所以呢，是好，必有征战，一定有征战。
Therefore, there will be war.
这件事情呢，是已经定了，没有已经定了。
This has been determined.
所以大家明白，所以要成为精兵哦，要上战场，要打仗的。
And that is why we must be good soldiers of God.
好，那么荒凉，结论是荒凉的事已经定了。
And all these desolations have already been determined.
这些不是兴旺的事情，都是荒凉的，都是摧毁我们信仰的，都是打击我们信仰的，叫做荒凉的事。
These are all messages of desolations, and it is detrimental to our faith.
特别在真教会里面。
Especially in the true church.
但是天使说这些事已经定了。
But
真教会有荒凉的事。已经定了。
But the angel said that all these abomination of desolations have been determined.
你就明白为什么我们讲到的人常常比较很谨慎的，甚至严厉的来提醒大家、勉励大家、警告大家。
That is why the sermon speakers they are very stern. They always warn and rebuke members.
因为真教会里面有荒凉的事，而且已经定了。
Because in the true church, there are these desolations that have been determined.
你难道你要属于那个荒凉的一份子吗？
Do you want to be a part of this desolation?
如果你要成为荒凉的一份子，让教会软弱的，让信仰软弱的，让自己无畏的，让自己不圣洁的，那就不用打仗了，可以啊。
If you want to be a
part, 你就不用听这种道理了，你就拒绝这种道理了，可以啊。
If you want to be a part of these desolations, then you do not need to purify yourself, and you can go ahead and defile.
你看到这讲到讲这种严厉道理的、悔改道理的这辈人的，你就骂他，就恨他啊，可以啊，那我讨厌你啊，我不想听你讲道啊，可以啊。
When you hear this,
这是你的选择来的。
When you hear sermons, that would rebuke you and to remind you to be more vigilant, you hate them, but this is your choice.
那么这样的情况是什么呢？
And what is this condition?
让荒凉更加荒凉。让教会的荒凉更加荒凉，也让自己更进入到荒凉里面，很大的荒凉里去。
You allow all these desolations to be even more desolate.
所以在二十六节里面呢，天使解释预言在真教会神的国里面有五件这种事情。
So the angel explained these five things that will happen in the church.
其实注意哦，这五件都是荒凉的事哦，都不是好事来的哦。
So these five matters concerning the church are not.
好像杀耶稣一无所有，你以为那是好事吗？那是很不应该的事来的。杀耶稣，看到吗？受膏者被杀。你以为是好事啊
？It is like the anointed being cut off, and he shall have nothing for himself. This is not something.
对耶稣来讲呢，对我们来讲是好事了，耶稣救我们了。但问题是，杀耶稣的人是好事吗？
For us,
杀耶稣人是很可怕的事呀。
For us, it may be a good thing because the salvation of God has been achieved. But then for those who kill Jesus, it would be a terrifying thing.
这样看下去，这五件事情里面没有一件是好的，没有一件事是兴旺的，都是荒凉的。
It looks as though all these five matters are not good for the church. These are desolations.
这是我们从天使的讲解当中二十六节看到的，看到的预言，看到的事实。
This is what we can see from the prophecy and the explanation of the angel.
今天我们进入到第十章。
Today we come to Daniel chapter 10.
那这里不是说必有战争的事吗？
Here it tells us that there will be battles and wars.
你看一讲呢，进入到第十章的时候就是战争。
When it comes to chapter 10, it is talking about this battle.
并且是属灵的战争，灵界的战争。
But it is a spiritual warfare.
那到我们不久我们进入到十一章的时候。
As we enter into chapter 11,
我们又看到又战争了，又不停的战争。
We can see another warfare.
十章也好，十一章也好，全章都是在讲战争的。
Whether it is chapter 10 or chapter 11, it is talking about warfare.
十章的是讲属灵战争。
Chapter 10 talks about the spiritual warfare.
那是天使跟魔鬼的战争。
That is the warfare between the angel and the devil.
十一章的是人与人之间的战争。
Chapter 11 talks about the warfare between man and man.
王跟王的战争，国跟国的战争。
Kings and kings and kingdoms and kingdoms.
都是这个世界的战争，都是人的战争，地上的战争。
It is a warfare between man.
就是刚才说的，必有战争的事，一定会有。
And just like it is mentioned, there will be war in the end.
马上十章跟十一章就让我们看到了，就是战争。
And、we can see right away in Daniel chapter 10 and 11.
好，我们来读第一节。
We read verse 1.
请念。
In the third year of Cyrus, king of Persia, a message was revealed to Daniel, whose name was called Belteshazzar. The message was true, but the appointed time was long, and he understood the message, and had understanding of the vision.
到第三节。
Verse 2, in those days, I, Daniel, was mourning 3 weeks. I ate no pleasant food, no meat or wine came into my mouth, nor did I anoint myself at all till 3 weeks were fulfilled.
好，这一段呢，但以理因为看到异象而悲伤了三个七日。
This passage tells us that Daniel was grieved for 3 weeks.
那时间在什么时候呢？
After seeing this vision, and what time was that?
时间是在波斯王古列的第三年，他悲伤二十一日。
It was during the reign, the third year reign of Cyrus, king of Persia, when he was very grieved.
那就是主前536年。
It was during it is in 536 BC.
当他看到这些异象的时候呢，这时候呢，以色列民已经回耶路撒冷重建圣殿了，知道吗？
When he saw this vision, the first wave of the Jews have already returned to Jerusalem to rebuild the temple.
而且已经回去最少有两年到三年了，已经正在重建，正在建圣殿了的。
They have gone back for perhaps 2 to 3 years, and they were already in the process of rebuilding the temple.
我们怎么知道呢？
How do we know?
因为古列王登基第一年的时候，当王的时候，第一年就已经下诏说回国了，第一年就叫他们回去了。那现在已经是第三年了，他们回去已经有两三年了。
It was in the first year of the reign of Cyrus, king of Persia, that he decreed the return of the Jews to Jerusalem to rebuild the temple.
好，那么
this is already third year.
那到古列第三年的时候，在第十章的时候呢，但以理的人生路，他的人生的这条道路也将要走完了。
So in chapter 10, the life of Daniel is already coming to its end.
我们怎么知道？
How do we know?
他少年时期就是十多岁到二十岁之间，他就被掳到巴比伦去了。
When he was still a youth, perhaps in his teens, he was exiled to Babylon.
那经过七十年后，七十年满就回国重建圣殿了。那七十年已经满了嘛，他们都回去两三年了啊。七十年加他，就算他二十岁被掳了，七十年加二十年七八九，那九十岁了。
Assuming that he was
已经是这时候，他第十章的时候，他已经是。差不多是九十岁的人了。
Assuming that he was exiled to Babylon when he was 20 years old, so after the 70 years captivity in Babylon, he would have been 90.
那到第十二章的时候，神也正式了，神说你不要再讲了啦，你去等吧，等候吧，等候安息吧。等候安息就是说你不要讲了，你就要死了，你不要讲这么多。你就要安息了，你就要安息了，你不要讲这么多，你就去等候那个福分到来，死亡的福分到来，真的是这样哎。
So in chapter 12, God told Daniel to go his way to the end, for he should rest.
他这个时候第十章看我们看第十章的时候 他已经也九十岁的人。
When we read chapter 10, he was already a man of more than 90 years old.
很老的老人了。
He is already an old man.
但是你看他这么老了，最后的岁月他还关心什么？他在意的是什么？
But despite his old age, what was he still concerned for?
好，这里继续说，古列第三年有事情，有事显给这个但以理看。
In the third year of the reign of Cyrus, king of Persia, there was this message that was revealed to Daniel.
有什么事要显给但以理看呢？
What was this message that was revealed to Daniel?
这里说，是指做大战争的事，有大战争的事要指给，指示给但以理看。
So it tells us that it was this long, this battle that will be revealed to him.
那所以从十章、十一章、十二章这最后三章全部都是大战争的意象。
The last three chapters of the book of Daniel are all pertaining to warfare.
然后呢，天使还说这些大战争的意象、大战争的事，这事是真的，都是真实的。
And the angel further said that all these regarding the battles, all these are true.
无论你从但以理书看，还是从启示录看，天使都一直的强调这事是真的，所说的是真的，所看的也是真的，所讲解的都是真的，一直强调这是真的。
Whether you read from here or from Daniel or elsewhere, you find that the angel always stressed that the message is true, whether you see it or hear it or speak it about it.
那真的就是假不了咯。
So if it is true, then it cannot be false.
那既然是真的，那必定会按着所说的来化身咯，因为是真的吗？
If it is true, then it will be fulfilled according to what is prophesied.
你注意看哦，其实你有时间你去找找看，常常都说这是真的，这是真实的，这是真的。真的还一直强调是真的。
If you were to read Revelation, you find that it is always stressed that this is true.
那一直强调是真的，但是有谁信呢？有谁把这个真的事放在心里呀？
But despite being stressed, you always read it as the message is true. Who will put it into their hearts?
外邦人不信，那当然嘛，因为他们都不信啊。他怎么会信圣经讲呢？他都不信神，他怎么会信圣经讲呢？
It is inevitable that the Gentiles do not believe because to start with, they do not believe
in God's word. 但是我们是信圣经、信神的人，信神说话的人。
But we who are God's children, we believe in God's words, we believe in God's
promises. 人就一直强调是真的。
And God always stressed that it is true.
那我们为什么还不认真呢？还不把它放在心里呢？还不紧张呢？
Then why are we not serious? Why do we not keep it in our hearts?
就好像真耶稣教会的真。
Just like in the truth, the name of the truth is a church.
这个真就是真的真啊，就是真实的真啊，就是真假的真啊，就是真理的真啊，就是真神的真啊。但是人家看到这个真，有认真的来查考吗？有认真的来尊敬吗？真的。
This true actually means the true church, referring to the true God with our true faith, truth, with the truth in us. But how many of us truly regard that?
看到这个真，不单只不会敬畏，反而讥笑啊！这个真的，人家都假的，还用个很轻浮的态度去面对这个真字。
Sometimes
这个就是真的呀，就像圣经就这个是真的呀。
Sometimes we do not even honor the word true in our true the name of our church, True Jesus Church.
当然，当我们说我们是真的时候，真耶稣教会真的时候，要经过考验的啦。当然经得起考验，经不起考验的真，那个就是假的。
Of course,
真实的真一定经得起考验。
Of course, when we say that our church is a True Jesus Church, then we should be able to pass the test.
真耶稣教会在1917到今天已经考验过被洪水冲击，被各种打击。到一百年了，知道吗？一百多年了，知道吗？我们还感谢神，他经过了许许多多的这种攻击、这种考验。
From the time our True Jesus Church was established in 1917, we have gone through many tests and many challenges.
就是因为这个真字、这个真字。
It is to do with this true, this word true.
如果这个真字是假的，不是真的，我们真耶稣教会早都倒了，哪里还有俄麦教会？你还要在这里啊？老实讲，我不会在这里。这个教会是假的，我在这里干嘛？我还在这里当传道，跟哪一点当传道开玩笑，我才不要。
If not, because,
我讲真的，我才不要。
If not because of the truth in our True Jesus Church, then this church in Gombak will not be in existence, and I will also not be a preacher.
为什么经过这么多打击，这么多磨练，这么多各种不公平的事情，我们还仍然继续坚持下去，继续存留下去？因为真的呀，真神、真理、真教会、真实都是真的。
The fact that we are able to persist through all these tests and challenges is because our church is true.
好，那接下去看第一节的下半段。
We read verse 1, the second portion.
这里说，但以理呢，通达这事，明白这意象。
It tells us that Daniel, he had understanding of the vision.
老实说，本来是不明白的啦。Initially,
he did not understand.
他自己也说嘛，不明白嘛。那么他问那个天使啊，是什么意思嘛？他都不明白啊。
Initially, he did not understand. That's why he asked the angel what it meant.
但是经过了天使的讲解，他就明白。But
after the explanation of the angel, he understood.
而且明白神的意象，明白神的旨意，就是神要我们明白。神其实就是要我们明白，并不是不要我们明白。Our
God wants us to understand His truth and not to for us to be confused.
那你不信，你看《但以理书》第8章。
If you do not believe, you can read Daniel chapter 8.
16-17节
Verses 16-17
我又听见乌来和两岸中有人呼喊说加百列啊就是那个天使加百列啊你要使到这个人但以理明白这个意象啊有声音说从神来的声音说你要让但以理明白这些意象明白这个神的旨意你要让他明白
Verse 16 tells us that there was this man's voice saying that Gabriel should be made understood about this vision.
那么加百列听到这个命令神的命令这个神的声音，17节他便马上就飞到但以理的所站的地方，就是但以理的面前，马上讲解，开始讲解这些意象。
When Gabriel heard this voice, immediately he flew to Daniel and he explained this vision to Daniel.
再看7章16节。
We read chapter 7, verse 16.
我就进去一个势力者，问他说：“这一切的真情到底是什么？”他就告诉我将那事的讲解给我明白。这些都一直在说明神的意思就是要我们明白他的意象、他的旨意。
All these verses tells us that God wants us to be very clear of His message and His will.
但愿每一个信徒都明白道理，都明白神的旨意，都明白神所说的。 甚至也明白奥秘。
It is hoped that all the believers, all the children of God, understand the words of God and even the mysteries of God.
但是我们很可惜，我们不读这个启示录，我们自己也谦卑，然后自己也怕说都不明白了，反正看也不明白的啦，讲也听不明白的啦，那就不读了，不听了，因为不明白的呀。
But sadly, sometimes we become, we are too humble and we do not want to continue reading Revelation and say that we do not understand.
我们上当了，被欺骗了。
We have fallen into the trap of the devil and we have been misled.
再困难，再难的解释，启示录都自己有答案，启示录自己都已经在解释。那又加上圣灵的带领，让我们带领那些传道工人来讲解，那我们更加清楚呀。
No matter how difficult the mysteries or how difficult it is to interpret the mysteries and the revelations in the book of Revelation, God is there to help us and the Holy Spirit will be there to help us too.
你看启示的时候都一样说，神的仆人都要明白，这些启示都要明白，神亲自的下命令说，大家都要明白。
If you were to read the book of Revelation, you'll find that God has already commanded that all of us must understand the words of the Revelation.
所以大家要明白神的道理，神的旨意，不要一直说我不明白，不明白你就要追求，不明白你就要祷告，不明白你就要谦卑的学习，谦卑的来认真的听。
Hence, all of us must pursue and learn the words of God and the revelations of Jesus Christ. If we do not understand, then we must diligently seek the word of God.
我们真教会的特色就是有天使、有圣灵的这种讲解带领，常常都有天使跟圣灵的见证。This
is the special characteristic of our True Jesus Church. We have the guidance of the Holy Spirit and the angels to reveal to us.
一样样，这个但以理的情形，天使讲解给他听。
It is likened unto the condition of Daniel at that time. The angel explained to him.
所以，我们真耶稣教会能够明白得救的真理，得救的福音，是因为圣灵的带领跟启示。
The fact that through Jesus Church is able to understand the gospel of salvation is because the Holy Spirit revealed it to us.
绝对不是我们今天的人研究出来的真理，绝对不是。
It is not something that we have researched it ourselves.
以前很多长老、执事、传道人没有什么度道书，可是对得救福音很坚持、很清楚，讲解的也很清楚，很肯定的。
Our early workers in our church, they were not very educated, but they were very convinced about our doctrines of salvation.
今天我们读了很多原文，我们读了很多的书，我们有了很多很多的参考书，我们也每年都有真理研究会，越研究越不清楚，越研究越解释，越让我们怀疑，越对以前所信的、所接受的，越来越感觉到有冲突。
Today,
真的是莫名其妙。
Today we may be so...
因为是研究出来的呀。
Today, we may be very educated, we may even know the original versions, but then we keep talking about researchers, and every year we even have this truth research committee.
老前辈是靠圣灵自己启示感动的呀，当然不一样啊，我们今天是靠自己的知识，然后靠一些神学的那些课本，那些人家写的书，那些资料，这样来研究出来的，那当然不一样啊，当然会走偏差呀。
Our early workers of the church, they relied on the revelation of the Holy Spirit and the guidance of God to interpret these doctrines of salvation. But today we have resorted to all these Bible scholars and theologians.
我还是深深感觉到，不用再怎么样研究了，得救福音真理哦，不用再怎样研究了，就是坚持下去就对了，研究别的吧。
Therefore,
研究让自己让信徒怎么样在兴旺在发展，我觉得这样会更真实啊。得救道理不用再研究了啦，什么洗脚你还要再深入研究，什么洗礼要深入的去探讨，结果没事找事来做呀，没问题找问题来找出很多问题来。
I believe that as far as the five doctrines of salvation is concerned, we do not need to have any more truth research into these topics.
那我的意思是说，我们不能研究，可以。但是你的研究一定要巩固我们所信的，并不是拆毁我们所信的，并不是动摇我们所信的。你的研究结论一定要更加强巩固了我们的基础，这样的研究才是合乎神的旨意啊，才合乎真理的要求呀。
If you want to research, then whatever you research must be able to strengthen and enhance our existing doctrines and not to shake it and to waver.
你花了很多时间很用心去研究出来的结果，那个结论是怀疑我们的信仰根据的，你这个研究我不要的， 我绝对不听的，甚至连讨论我都懒得跟你讨论。这个不是我骄傲，这是因为我单纯，你太复杂了。
If we have spent much time and effort into researching all this truth using other church materials or other Bible scholars and theologians materials, then maybe we should.
其实骄傲的才是真正的对方啊，用自己的研究出来的，哇，好厉害啊！真正的骄傲才是对方啊，我们反而是很单纯的呀，很简单的。
We should be innocent and simple in just accepting the Bible doctrines of God.
我今天为什么讲到这里呢？
Why do I say so?
就是哈，但以理哈听了天使的解释，哦，有天使的这种带领，他就明白通达这事，明白这个意象，这个就是真耶稣教会的体验，真耶稣教会的见证来的。
I say this because Daniel was the angel explained this to Daniel, and because of that, he understood the word and he understood the vision. So today in our church, we will have this understanding from the angel.
看第二节，第二节。
Chapter verse two.
当那个时候，请问是什么时候呢
？In those days, and what kind of days were those?
就是他看的这个大战争异象的那个时候。
This is the time when he saw the vision of the great conflict.
那么这个异象的重点是有关本国之民。日后要遭遇的事情， 这些异象，大战争的异象呢，都是有关本国之民将来要发生的事情。
This vision of the great conflict is what will befall them, befall the country and the people in the near future.
我们怎么知道呢
？How do we know this?
你看十四节啊。
You read verse 14.
天使说：“我现在来，就是要使到你明白，本国之民就是神的国，以色列国，以色列民。”日后他必要遭遇的事，因为这个异象关乎将来很多的日子， 所以这个意象呢是关乎神的国神的百姓将来要遭遇的事。
Verse 14, it tells us that the angel came to Daniel to help him understand what is to happen to his people in the last days.
这就是这些意象的重点来的，它的目的来的。
This is the purpose of the vision, is for to explain the days yet to come.
那但以理看过之后呢，他就大大的愁苦，浑身无力啊，看到吗
？After Daniel saw this vision, he was very weak and he had no energy left.
看十六十七节哦
，Verses 16 to 17。
不料有一位向人的摸我的嘴唇，我便开口向那站在我面前的说：“我主啊，因为见这个异象，我大大的愁苦，因为见到这种异象，这种幕后的神国的异象，我很忧伤啊，甚至我没有力气啊。”
Daniel said, because of this vision, he had no more, he had no strength in him, and there was no breath left in him.
十七节他再次讲到，我一见到这个异象，我就浑身无力，毫无气息。
Verse 17, he repeated and said, after seeing the vision, he had no more strength in him, and no breath is left in him.
你知道为什么吗？
Do you know why?
其中一个原因。
One of the reasons.
一个人太过忧伤，看到太过忧伤、悲伤的事情的一种自然状态。
This is a natural reaction when someone is too grieved.
整个人大大的愁苦，然后整个人没有力气，连站都没有力气站，好像要倒，要跌，要跌这样。
They will be so grieved and sorrowful that they will have no strength left.
你有没有这样的体验过呢？这样的情形呢
？Have you experienced this before?
我们传道人常常主办丧礼甚至要埋葬的时候，我就看过好几次，亲眼看过，体验到对方啊家属的那种悲伤，整个人没有力了。要人家扶着他，为什么？他太悲伤了，他有时哭不出来啊。可是他的内心太愁苦，整个人没有力气，连脸色都没有脸色去，这是表示太悲伤。
During funeral or burial services, when the bereaved family they are so grieved, we often see that they have no strength left even to stand on their own.
加上他又九十岁的身体，身体的那种力量也是衰败了，老人家呢？
The thing that Daniel at that time, he was more than 90 years old, so he's already a very old man.
我在解释为什么见了异象会有这样的反应，没有力气
啊。I'd like to explain why he had no energy left in him after seeing this vision.
因为他一直强调大大的愁苦，那个是悲伤啊，悲伤过度。
Because he reiterated that he was greatly grieved.
那看过之后呢，但以理又悲伤了三个七日，那就是二十一天。
He was greatly grieved for 21 days, that is 3 weeks.
第二节。
Verse 2.
当那时我但以理悲伤了三个七日，悲伤一天两天都已经很厉害了悲伤到二十一天你想想看
To think that Daniel was mourning for 3 weeks, to mourn for two days is already bad.
只能够说，如果你的心没有这么爱神的殿没有这么爱以色列民族的你没有办法悲伤二十一日的。
All I can say that if he did not love God and His temple and His children, His people so much, he would not have been so grieved for 2 weeks.
他是在王宫几十年享受的人，在王宫生活的人，高水准、高生活、高品质、高享受的那个环境来的。
He was one who enjoyed all the pleasures of the palace. He enjoyed his high status in faith.
又经过巴比伦的王宫，现在又经过波斯帝王的王宫，什么享受没有看过？什么享受没有遇到
？He lived during the reign of Babylon, and now in this time is Persia.
但是我们看到他心里的唯一的关心的、唯一最爱的就是神、神的殿、神的名这三件事：神、神的殿、神的名。他就是这三件事，他的最爱，也是最关心的，也是让他最痛的，也是这三件事。
So nothing would have, no other enjoyment would have eluded him, except that he was very concerned for God, his temple, and his people at this point in time.
那就是真正爱神、爱教会、爱弟兄姐妹的信徒来的啦。
And you can say that Daniel was one who really loved God and really loved the
people. 那么，在这个二十一天里面，他有三个没有。
In this 21 days time.There were three things that he did not have.
第一个没有就是美味我没有吃，美味我没有吃。
The first one is he did not eat of any delicacy.
美味就是说他很喜爱吃的事物很美妙，很喜欢吃的东西
Delicacy refers to those things that he would love to eat.
好像我喜欢吃炸鸡我没有吃。
For example, I like roast chicken, but I cannot eat.
我喜欢吃茶粿条，我没有吃。我喜欢吃云吞面，我没有吃。
I like char kway teow or I like wonton mee, but I cannot
这个叫做美味，我没有吃，知道吗？ So, 你最喜欢这东西，你都21天都不吃。
So this is what it means. He ate no delicacies.
再来，酒肉第二个没有，就是酒肉没有入我的口。
The second thing is he did not eat meat or wine.
这个说明了什么？
What does this say?
这个说明了除了这悲伤的21天没有喝酒没有吃肉，那么其他的日子就是正常的享用，喝酒吃肉吃美味，其他日子就是这样生活。
In other words, during this 3 weeks period, he did not eat any of these delicacies, nor meat, nor wine.
这里都讲得很清楚啊。
So here it tells us very clearly.
他没有吃，是这21天没有吃这些美味啊，酒跟肉啊。那过了这21天，那就是满，看到吗？马知道满了三个七日21天，那么就正常了，就有吃了， 就有喝了，就有享受美食了。所以我们是对一章八节，当你说一章八节不吃王的宴席啊，只喝白开水，只吃青菜，我们误解了。许多老师误解说他就是一生都是吃素的，吃白开水的，分别为圣的，我们误解了。
In Daniel chapter 1 verse 8, we often say that Daniel was one who refrained from meat and he was a vegetarian. But in Daniel chapter 10, we can read that it is only during the period of the 21 days that he abstained from delicious food, wine and meat.
在第十章第二节第三节、啊、第三节里面、啊、但是你自己爆料啊，我只是，你们不要误会我，我没有这么厉害，我也不需要这么厉害，我只是21天没有吃这些罢了，不要把我想到这样属灵，而且也不需要这种属灵，不需要，就是过正常生活，想吃就吃，想喝就喝，过正常生活，他自己爆得了啊。我们现在从这里来看呢、啊，哦，原来他有吃呢，我们几高兴啊，因为我有吃嘛。
So in a way, verses 2 and 3, Daniel explained himself that he too ate of this delicious food, meat and wine.
好，那么就是说其他日子就恢复一切的平常，一切正常、啊、
It is only the period of 3 weeks that he abstained from this food, but after that he went back to this food.
这也关系到我们进食的问题了，进食的道理。
So this has got to do with our doctrine about fasting.
所以有特别事情才进食了，没有什么事情你不要进食。
So we fast.
耶稣也说不用了，你为什么要多做的呢？这种东西。
We fast only when we have special matters to pray for. Even Jesus said that we do not need to.
我们要表示我们对神的虔诚，对神的圣洁，对神还有很多很多方法，实实在在的方法，很多呀。
If you want to show your sincerity to God, there are many other ways.
难道你早上一餐不吃就叫做虔诚了吗？早上一餐不吃，哇，我早上一餐不吃，那我十二点我就吃了。那早上一餐不吃，你就祷告就要听你了吗？祷告就神就要怎么样怎么样怜悯你了吗？有时我们想的太简单了吧，也甚至把神想的太简单了吧。
Does it mean that
这样容易，不要说糊弄了，糊弄不好意思了，这样容易这样就被我们这样过，这样糊弄过去的呀。主啊，我近视，那原来就是早餐没有吃呀。
Does it mean that just because
许多人早餐没有吃的，你知道吗？
Just because you fasted for the breakfast and you eat at 12 o'clock, God has to answer your prayer. There are many people who will go hungry and have no food to eat for the breakfast.
但是真的，如果心里很痛苦，真的有事情，我们要认真进食，那都是个人静静的，个人安静的，人家甚至不知道。主耶稣也一直强调说，不要让人家知道。
But of course,
静静的自己在祷告。
But of course, if you truly have a problem, then you can quietly and fast quietly fast and pray. Even Jesus said that when you fast,
然后在我们的面前，在弟兄姐妹面前还要装的说像平时这样没什么事发生啊，就是有梳头，有穿美美，就是好像正常啊。
Even if
还要这样
，Even if we fast, we must anoint ourselves and do not let others know that we are fasting.
那如果要进食，就是说那就这样了，这样还是 OK 的。
Our Lord Jesus said, even if you want to fast, never let anyone.
搞到全世界人都知道，大家很轰动的时候，一次、两次、三次、四次的时候，长久这样的时候，我们就要检讨，我们就觉得会走差，开始走差，因为不是这样的，道理也不是这样的，方法也不是这样的。
If our fasting prayer has become a routine, then perhaps we should examine ourselves.
那我从这里顺便这样讲， 满了二十一次，知道满了三个次数，那就 OK 了。
So here in this case, he was only abstaining from this delicious meat and wine for a period of 3 weeks.
我今天就第十章就讲到这里就好了，第三节。
I shall stop here.
我们还没有进入到属灵战灵界战争哦。
We have not gone into the spiritual warfare yet.
那么我们星期六再说吧。
We shall continue this on Saturday.
来唱诗。
Let us sing him.
169首。
169.
这首诗是因为、再看下去会看到天使跟魔鬼的征战。
As we sing this hymn, because as we read Daniel, we will see the spiritual warfare between the angel and the devil.
但是到底什么事情、影响到天上的天使会跟魔鬼征战呢？什么事情呢？
But what is the matter that resulted in this warfare between the devil and the angel?
这个是但以理书第十章里面一个值得我们去深思的问题，去思考的问题。
This is one important matter that we should reflect upon in Daniel chapter 10.
因为但以理21天的祷告。
Because of Daniel's prayer for 21 days.
就是因为这种认真的祷告。
Because of his earnest prayer for 21 days.
看起来是我跟神的事情啊。
It looks as though it is a matter between God and me.
因为这样的祷告，在灵界起了战争啊。
But this has
牵动了魔鬼跟天使的征战。
But this prayer of Daniel has resulted in the spiritual warfare between the angel and the devil.
这个是灵界当中一个很奇妙的地方，一个很值得我们要去深入思考的事情来的。
This is something that we should reflect upon.
那圣经记录很天使啊，就是因为那个天使要来告诉这个但以理这个消息嘛，这个讲解嘛。
This is what
魔鬼就拦阻他，不给他讲了。 不给他明白啊。
This is what is recorded in Daniel. The angel wanted to come to explain to Daniel, but it was restrained by the devil.
那么丹尼尔就是祷告求明白啊，求神让他明白啊。
Daniel only prayed to God to help him to understand.
怎么会想到会灵界的会战争呢？这样的事情。
He never knew that it would result.
所以我们哦，我们的所作所为，你祷告也好，你不祷告也好，你行歪路也好，你行正路都好，都牵动灵界战争的，知道吗？
So let us be mindful.
魔鬼跟天使因为我们来战争的，你知道吗？
Let us be mindful that whatever we do, whether we are upright or otherwise, there will also be battle between the devil.
这个是在但以理书十章很清楚的一个很清楚的一件事情。
This is something that is very clear even in Revelation.
我们来祷告。
We all pray together.
奉主耶稣圣名祷告，哈利路亚！感谢赞美主耶稣，哈利路亚！哈利路亚！ 感谢主耶稣，阿们。我依靠主，常常有胜利，胜利。我依靠主，常常有胜利。得胜恩主，常看顾，时刻伸手在扶助。我依靠主，常常有胜利。我依靠主，常常有胜利，胜利。我依靠主，常常有胜利。得胜恩主，常看顾，时刻伸手在扶助。我依靠主，常常有胜利。阿们。感谢主，阿们。感谢主耶稣祝福带领晚上的聚会。
We thank God for blessing and guiding us in our evening service.
聚会到这里结束。
Our service ends here.
大家起立，呼祷平安。
Please arise, greetings of peace.
哈利路亚。
哈利路亚。
啊，再见。